Mr. Stepien has been in the campaign field for a long time, and he worked for lots of different candidates and campaigns. He testified to this committee about his concerns, given the claims that Mr. Giuliani and Ms. Powell and their team were making publicly. Let's play clip 15.
Okay, and was it important for you, Mr. Stepien, to sort of pull back just for your own professional reputation? You didn't want to be associated with some of what you were hearing from the Giuliani team and others that sort of stepped in the wake of your departure?
I didn't mind being categorized. There were two groups of, we called them kind of my team and Rudy's team. I didn't mind being characterized as being part of Team Normal, as reporters, kind of started to do around that point in time. I said, hours ago, early on, that, I've been doing this for a long time, 25 years, and I've spanned, political ideologies from Trump to McCain to Bush to Christie, I can work under a lot of circumstances for a lot of varied, candidates and politicians, but situation where, and I think along the way I've built up a pretty good, I hope, a good reputation for being honest and professional, and I didn't think what was happening was necessarily honest or professional at that point in time. So yeah, that led to me stepping away.
So the president did get rid of Team Normal, and I'd like to play a clip showing that the president found the people he needed to perpetuate his claims of fraud.
They saw a big truck bringing in 100,000 ballots in garbage cans, in waste paper baskets, in cardboard boxes, and in shopping baskets. And every single one of them was for Biden, because they were being notified by Smartmatic in Frankfurt that Biden was way behind and they better come up with a lot more ballots, and we can prove every single thing I just said. If you gave me the paper ballots, I could probably turn around each one of these states. I'm absolutely convinced if you let me examine each one of those ballots, I'd pull out enough that were fraudulent that it would shake the hell out of the country.
It can set and run an algorithm that probably ran all over the country to take a certain percentage of votes from President Trump and flip them to President Biden, which we might never have uncovered had the votes for President Trump not been so overwhelming in so many of these states that it broke the algorithm.
I remember that one of the things Mark said at some point was, you can't show an actual vote was flipped, which I found at the time to be a remarkable assertion, because because you don't have to have the gun to see the body lying on the floor bleeding out with 5 bullet holes in it was killed by a gun.
What they were proposing, I thought, was nuts. And then the theory was also completely nuts, right? I mean, it was a combination of Italians, Germans. I mean, different things have been floating around as to who was involved. I remember Hugo Chavez and the Venezuelan. She has an affidavit from somebody who says they wrote a software in and something with the Philippines, and just all over the radar.
Did you ever share, Mr. Kushner, your view of Mr. Giuliani? Did you ever share your perspective about him with the president?
I guess yes.
Tell me what you said.
Basically, not the approach I would take if I was you.
Okay. And how did he react? How did President Trump react when you shared that view with him?
He said, I have confidence in Rudy.
I think I had conversations with probably all of our counsel who are signed up to assist on Election Day as they disengaged with the campaign. The general consensus was that the law firms were not comfortable making the arguments that Rudy Giuliani was making publicly. I seem to recall that I had a similar conversation with most all of them.
I made it clear I did not agree with the idea of saying the election was stolen and putting out this stuff, which I told the president was bullshit. And, you know, I didn't want to be a part of it. And that's one of the reasons that went into me deciding to leave when I did.
Even Sidney Powell, defending herself in a defamation lawsuit brought by Dominion Voting Systems, argued that, quote, no reasonable person would conclude that her statements were truly statements of fact. Mr. Chairman, I yield back.